Now, a novel beloved by several generations of readers is a major dramatic television series, and it comes riding a wave of interest after the election of President Donald Trump. Jeffrey Brown has the story.
When they slaughtered Congress, we didn't wake up. When they blamed terrorists and suspended the Constitution, we didn't wake up then either.
In this world, America's democracy and constitution have fallen, replaced by a theocratic autocracy called Gilead.
I have to let you go.
A place where women have lost the right to work or own property, where many of them are property.
You girls will serve the leaders and their barren wives. You will bear children for them.
The so-called handmaids are valued and controlled for their ability to reproduce in a future America where most women are infertile. Designated by their bonnets and red dresses, they're kept under an ever-watchful eye.
There's an eye in your house.
I made sure that every horrific detail in the book had happened sometime, somewhere. So think of it as a cake in which I made the cake, but all of the raisins and chocolate chips are real.
The series, The Handmaid's Tale, is based on the classic 1985 novel of the same name by Canadian author Margaret Atwood. She calls it speculative fiction.
I get in trouble over making a distinction between sci-fi and spec fic, but my only point is that there is a difference between a galaxy far, far away and this planet really could happen now.
Atwood mixed elements of totalitarian systems of the past, including the Soviet system, and strains of American life, from the Puritans to the rise of the Christian right in the 1980s. The novel found an audience from the start and has kept it, never going out of print and joining high school and college reading lists across the country.
Only a very few women could still bear children. These women were called handmaids.
It's been adapted for opera, ballet, and the 1990 film starring Robert Duvall and Natasha Richardson. And now this Hulu series starring Elizabeth Moss, who read the book as a teenager, playing Offred, a handmaid just assigned to a new household.
The glass is shatterproof, but it isn't running away they're afraid of. A handmaid wouldn't get far. It's those other escapes. The ones you can open in yourself, given a cutting edge. Or a twisted sheet and a chandelier.
I love that the heroine of the book is an anti-heroine, that she's a human, that she's a wife, a mom, is a normal person, and then is sort of picked up, taken, and dropped into this scenario and has to figure out how to survive. She does a sort of thing that often prisoners will do, which is they have to adapt to the prison environment and they have to hold their, you know, enemies closer than their friends.
The series is striking in how disturbing it is, both in the dark vision of society it portrays and at the same time its beautiful look, a combination sought by series showrunner Bruce Miller and executive producer Warren Littlefield.
You recognize this world. It's a beautiful world. They want it to be cleaner. They want the food to be healthier. They're trying to raise fertility rates. Those are all good things. That's very inviting. So we come into our world and it feels pretty good until you look closely.
Dystopia in our time has kind of been synonymous with rubble and dust and robots and scrounging around for food. This is just a different kind of dystopia. Doesn't have dirty in it. It's just a terrible reality.
I asked Miller and Littlefield about working on this series, where so much is about what happens to women.
I tried my best, along the way to shore up that part of my personality that I couldn't change, that part of who I am that I couldn't change, by hiring, as many people who were kind of spectacular women's voices, either with Reed Morano, our director, or, Lizzie Moss, of course, our star, but also, our writing staff is predominantly women. I think we had all female directors except for...
4 out of 5 of our directors for the 10 hours are women. And many of our department heads, wardrobe and production designer, we really built a very strong core of women who brought this show to life, because for that very reason, we're not.
The idea for the series and the shooting began well before the election of Donald Trump, but since November, Atwood's book has returned to the bestseller list, and the series is generating many questions of parallels to today.
There's a huge sort of awakening amongst people my age and people in their 20s and younger with what's happening now, as far as, oh wait, someone can actually take that away from us. It's a brand new concept to a lot of women.
And I think one of the things that's happened to them is rights were won for them long ago, and they just took them for granted. Their interests were other. And then suddenly, bang, a light bulb goes on. Maybe somebody's going to take these rights away. And that may happen in all areas of life, including healthcare, minimum wage, and including forcing people to have babies.
That's not very hopeful.
Well, it's not me making this absence of hope.
But you can write the future. You can write a more hopeful future.
I could, but I would have to make it plausible, would I not? So I do believe that America is quite an ornery and diverse place. And I don't think people are going to roll over easily for this. But a totalitarian gets serious the moment at which it fires on a protest crowd.
The first three episodes premiere Wednesday on Hulu. After that, episodes will come out weekly. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown.
And we have more online. Author Margaret Atwood explains her inspiration for the blood-red costumes worn by the handmaids in the novel and in the new adaptation. You can find that and more on our website, pbs.org/newshour.